It's time! It's time! It's JFW time!
All right, guys, it's that time to get us up in the ring with the greatest faction in podcast history, Jazz Freak Wrestling, the JFW Podcast, hosted by Travesty.
I am Nubby, the Amazing Turtle.
And I am PX, Pacman, the Podcast Papa, Mr. Acromania, and I'm back.
That's a lot of accolades there.
Take that, Shawn Michaels.
Damn.
A lot of self accolades right there.
Hey, an accolade's an accolade. So if it is self, he's self loving himself.
It's that time of the year, you know.
No, I don't know. I don't fucking know.
All right, well, you're back.
I am.
That's a thing.
I missed you guys. Did you miss me, Travis?
How you doing, Nubby?
I'm all right, I guess.
Yeah.
Well, it's going to be a goofy show because of a live video recording that happened yesterday with Rion, Max Holiday, Steve, and myself that we're going to kind of hopefully get you and Rion to discuss your side of it because you weren't there to, you know, have your part in that. So hopefully we get that done. I just got to see whenever Rion's available and all that jazz. It's Pac-Man's birthday.
Happy birthday, my man.
Thanks, Nubby. Thank you.
So celebrating 29 years of dwelling in the parents' basement. Congrats, buddy.
Just about. I appreciate
that. Just about, yeah.
Just about. Give or take a couple years.
I did want to pay respects to you for your birthday. So I'm going to drink this. Delicious blueberry smash.
Okay.
From Steam Hollow Brewing.
Is that the one that tastes like, that's the one that tastes like breakfast, right?
No.
I'm thinking a different one.
That's that maple or something.
That one was good.
This one tastes like blueberries, hence blueberry smash.
I mean, you can have blueberries on your pancakes if you
sure
want.
Sure can.
You could.
Sure could.
100%. I mean, I would never. That's just not me.
You're not a blueberry syrup guy?
No.
Love blueberry syrup. Also love pecan syrup.
Not big fan.
So, happy birthday, Pac-Man.
Appreciate it, Travis. Thank you.
And here's to you.
Yep.
Cheers. A couple of announcements before we dive into the show. This past weekend on this freaking show, I interviewed Warren C. Freiberg, the III Esquire. Talk about his weight loss journey along with his fiance Tara. So if you guys get a chance, please check that out. Last week, the Lovely Intoxicated Podcast released an interview with Gunner Brave. You find that on YouTube and Facebook, Lovely Intoxicated Men. And I guess that's it.
The power hour. Won't be having a regular show this week.
I felt so bad. I had to message Steve last week and apologize that I gave the wrong schedule. I just felt so bad about that.
They're going to air the live show they did the day before the IPW show. It's gonna be really weird, considering I know what happened that day, what was said, and you just think about all the shit that's happened since, and it's like, can we go? Maybe we should go back to that day so I could stop that from happening.
Well, like I said, I'm gonna try to get Rion on. He said he was available. We'll try to get him on to talk about whatever you guys need to hash out and talk about, other than your displeasure with me being there, which I don't know why that was the first thing you commented on. That hurt my feelings. Like, I didn't belong. How dare you? But
it's not that you didn't belong. It was
just between the two of us, I wasn't the right choice.
No, it's just that the power hour was there, at least two of them. Yeah. And then it was just you of JFW.
Yeah.
And I'm like, well, wait a minute. How come I'm not part of it?
I think what it really was it was the two hosts of the morning after having two hosts of two other shows.
Okay, we can look at that way.
Well, because I remember, like, once we were done recording, I asked them, I was like, whatever happened to, like, the morning after come back? And they're like, that's what this just was. And I was like, oh. Yeah, you were missed. Wish you were there. It would be fun to hang out with you, too. Pacman, I didn't give a shit if you were there or not. I made it a lot better.
I just feel so heartbroken, Travis.
I don't care.
The cockles of my heart are just shattering at the seams.
I don't care. You're okay. Cockled?
My cockled. Not my cockled.
Your cockled heart?
Not that either.
Your cockled fucking heart?
I don't know. I used a word. Sometimes I use words the wrong way. I don't know if I use that word the right way, but I'm just going to run with it.
Tell you what.
You're not the only one who uses words.
Google that fucking word and tell me if you used it right or not.
I will let you know.
I just got a message from Rion. So I'm going to try to get him on here. While I'm doing this, I want to remind all you guys that this episode of this freaking show is brought to you. There we go. Got two sips in. This episode of Just Freak Wrestling is brought to you by CarterComics.com. It's a one-stop shop for all your comic needs, whether it be graded or raw. Carter Comics has got them all. Go to CarterComics.com, fill up your cart with all their amazing comics. Again, whether it be graded or raw. At checkout, use the discount code FREAKNET, that's FREAKNET. You'll save 10% on your entire order. Not just at the website, but also on their four different eBay accounts that they own. And you can find links to all four of those accounts on their homepage at CarterComics.com. Again, CarterComics.com is a proud sponsor of the podcast, Just Freak Wrestling, This Freak Show, as well as FreakNet Studios. Okay, let me get Rion on here. We'll see when he's ready. And we'll get your guys' conversation going.
And hello.
Hey, Rion, how you doing, sir?
All right. I'm messing this all up.
Oh, you're fine, man. You're fine. So, again, I want to say thank you for the invite yesterday. It was a lot of fun hanging out with you, Steve, and three-time longest reigning SCW heavyweight champion Max Holiday. Thank you for sharing with me the Dutch baby. It's to this moment today, still a fantastic, delicious treat. But we're gonna look beyond all of that, because the biggest reason you're here is because Nubby would like to talk with you about what we discussed yesterday. And I don't want to Steve this. I don't want to interrupt people while they're talking. So I'm going to.
That is the thing that happens.
Right. I'm not gonna hold up a picture of some nobody and call a timeout and all that jazz.
That's not a nobody. That is an up and comer.
What's his name?
Ryan Matthews.
He's undeniable.
He is undeniable. So, for those of you who didn't get a chance to listen to or watch the video, make sure you check it out. It is up on Facebook. You can find it through Rion's Facebook. I'm tagged in it. It's on my Facebook, Steve, Max Holiday. Check that out as reference to this conversation. But, Pacman, I know it's your birthday, but I'm going to request you shut up as well. And
no problem.
Nubby, if you're ready, man, please feel free to have your conversation with Rion. And hopefully when this is all over, we could all move on from this.
Okay. Just a heads up, I am driving at the moment. Yeah. So I'm trying to, as soon as I am parked, I will do videos. I'm not even sure if I'm on the thing here, but you can hear what I'm saying, so it works out. But I'm just letting you know that I'm driving. So my apologies for about 10 minutes or so. If I need to mute it, I will. Just let me know. I don't know how it sounds. That's where my head is.
It sounds like you're driving, but it's not an overbearing sound. I'm totally okay with it. Stay just the way you are. That way you get a chance to respond to whatever Nubby says.
Nubby, I'm going to
mute myself for a moment so I don't have to interfere in any way by accident. So the floor is yours.
Thank you, Travis. Hello, Rion. How are you today?
I'm okay. Just driving. Just moving along.
Perfect. Glad everything's good. All right. Before we get into like almost everything that was said, I just want to know right off the bat, why did we have to make it a public thing yesterday?
That's what the morning after is. And you already know that because you've been on the morning after, like, you've actually been on the morning after, so you already know, like, what it is. My thing, as far as how everything was happening, and this is just in general, is that I feel, and this is just me, I feel like if you're going to tell it right. And there's a couple things that were online, as far as people making it out to be a shoot, when I'm pretty sure that not on my end, at least. But I also understand, like, for what you're trying to do, and especially in that particular match, like, there's certain things that have to be done. And when I hear people say that this is a shoot, I'm like, that's not what it is. But I can't just say, no, it's not, without giving context of things. And if you're going to tell it, and this is just how I've been, you have to tell it right, or at least give context to what's taking place. The way that, and this is just me in general, there's a lot of stuff that took place with the two of us, not just from that, but just in general, as far as me helping you along with certain aspects of wrestling. Because believe it or not, I am a fan of yours. I've explained that to you directly. But at that particular point, that was one of those, especially with everything that was taking place with it was eating at me, and to the point that I was considering leaving being informational liaison. And that, because that's a conflict of interest, and that can't be a thing, because it's like that's why I was like, something has to be said. It has to. But I have to put it in perspective of people that feel like it is a shoot, the ones that were like directly involved. That was like, no, you probably should know more as far as what's happening with everything. Because I can't do it on the Power Hour. Let's be real. Can't. And I'm kind of, and the way that everything is structured on the on this very format, I can, but I can't, because of the way the continuity works. Does that make sense?
I mean, I get, yet the it did need to be explained to maybe certain people, but the way I look at it is, the rest of the world didn't need to know.
Is that your honest? That's okay. Then the only thing that I can say is my apologies for putting that situation out there. But here's the thing. The indie ring has that footage out there. Other fans have the footage out there. People are thinking that it's a shoot. What else am I supposed to do? If everyone is saying, oh, it's a shoot, it's a shoot, it's a shoot, and it's like, no, it's not. You need context. Because it's no different than what took place as far as, like I said, with previous morning afters. You're going to tell it right. Not one time did I say anything that was bad. At least I don't think I said anything bad. Was there anything that was disrespectful towards you as far as how it was presented?
It's just, it's not toward like disrespect towards me. It is more of we gave away too much, or you guys gave away too much of behind the scenes and like putting matches together and all that. I think that was too much for people that weren't there, or even the people that were there. They actually didn't need to know all the details. If they thought it was a shoot, let them think it. I think, and isn't it our job, whether we are shooting or not, to make the in-ring stuff look somewhat real anyway?
Agreed. Here's my rebuttal. You can do that on the Power Hour, and you can do that on Just Freaking Wrestling. Or, yeah, you can do that there. However, you've been on the morning after. You've vented on the morning after in the past. Things that you want to say, because it's neutral ground. Everything is just there. It's on the table. It's no different than anything that has been said on there. But it's also being said, because I can clearly say that not everything has been given, because it's just perspective. If you honestly feel like whatever I said was disrespectful towards you and your character, my apologies for thinking that me just stating just factual scenarios is a problem. I can't, it's a matter of perspective, I can't take that back. But I will not apologize for stating facts. I will not have, because it wasn't like I just went on there and just said, well, this is what I think. Travis T was on there to verify if something was happening during the match. Steve, who was in the match, was there to verify or on his end. But he verified things that was happening with me, not you. Yes, there were things that were being said as far as your part in things, but I was talking as far as the story that I dealt with, what was happening with me. Giving away stuff has always been my thing as far as the morning after as a whole, and I will never take that away. The problem is now is that everyone said, as I said yesterday, that people want to blur the line until they don't. It's neutral ground. There's no continuity errors when it comes to dealing with the morning after. We can just have a conversation, a legitimate conversation, to where I don't have to worry about multiple storylines. We can just talk. If you have an honest question that you want, I'll answer it. Make it for everybody always. Because we're just having a conversation. At least that's what I thought was happening. But it's not, and this is just as far as my scenario alone, that I can't speak for you. Everything that was in my brain, everything that I had to word it very, very specifically, because I wanted you, knowing that you're on the line, knowing that you're in the chat, to understand that it's not even, I'm not saying anything bad. I'm not saying you messed up, you did this thing. No, I'm at fault. Especially now that I know that I was the veteran of the scenario, I should have just handled it accordingly, but I was dealing with everything else. So I take fault in that, but I will not apologize for telling the truth. I won't. Especially when it comes to this. Because I meant what I said. I want you to know that we should just next time work with each other instead of that. I stand by that 100%.
I get all that. Like, trust me, I'm regretting a lot of mind my mind fucked that day, regretting a lot of things. But it, like, before we get into like all that stuff, it's just, and maybe you're right. When it comes to letting the public know what happened, what took place, I just still feel like it shouldn't have been public. It should have just been within your conversation at breakfast, and maybe certain people within the business, like privately. I had this big issue of it being out on Facebook Live.
Okay, that's fair. My rebuttal to that is that the same way that you're telling me that certain people in the business need to handle certain things, you still have Pacman on your panel. That's right. Still a thing. Like, I get what you're saying, but as far as blurring the line and keeping certain things in the business, Pacman has never wrestled, yet he's part of your panel. And you respect him in the same way as anything else because he has a different viewpoint of things. It's just a matter of perspective. I completely understand where you're coming from as far as certain things don't need to be said. Fair. However, you've watched the morning after previously. Yeah. Has there ever, we've talked about matches, good and bad, right and wrong. If we're in the wrong, I'll say it. If we get anything wrong, if someone listens to it and we get something wrong, we'll admit to it. But we can only talk about our own experiences. Not one time did I go on there and start talking about the entire IPW show. Steve tried to do that. And it's like, well, I get it. But it's never been, we need to put the results in. We never do this. It's myself and Max's own personal experience. As far as what we're dealing with, very rarely do we go through results and everything of the sort. Here's this thing that happened. Let's talk about it. Good or bad, right or wrong. Let's see, funny or not, funny or serious. Let's talk about it. Let's just, the two of us, let's talk about it. This was a trial run. If you are honestly bothered by that, I am sorry, but it was not meant to be any malice scenario. Not even in the slightest. If you go back and look at it, everything that I was saying, it was not projected in a malice scenario. It was, hey, how do you feel about this? What would you do? How would this, like, simple stuff? Or at least I tried to keep it simple. But I digress.
Yeah, I get it. That morning after stuff, like, maybe I should have known. I just assumed that the situation happened, and I just didn't think it would ever be brought up publicly. I thought maybe certain people would know, or it would be brought up during the meeting at the next IPW show, and I just take the standing ovation of being a fuckhead that day or whatever. But I get it now. So
you are a fuckhead. That's just it.
I just say things. It's just me being weird, you know.
Well, no, I get that part, but you're not a fuckhead. I already admitted fault as the veteran, because keep in mind, I've just found out that I was a veteran of the match yesterday. And had I known that, I would have handled things accordingly. Like it's me being real. I found out about that yesterday as far as being a vet. And if I knew that I was going to be the one that was handling the match, I would have handled it differently. Period. There's no ifs, ands, or buts about it.
And that day, I did say you were the vet. But you probably, it went over your head with everything going on. Well, clearly it did.
And once again, for that, my apologies. I don't even know what to say about that, other than my apologies for missing that. But based on everything that was going on, as far as things that you wanted to do and things you wanted to get out, it's like, let's roll with it. We just have to do this other thing. But knowing the scenario now, I should have took the lead. Had I known, it would have been different. I can't take that back.
So with all that said, I guess we can get into that part. So... Now, I know you're saying you should have taken the lead after knowing you're the vet, but even if I, you still probably could have given me kind of the lead, see how it went. Maybe I thought you were testing me. I'm not sure. So I presented you with the idea. Now, in my experience, whether I'm a vet working with a green guy, you know, someone who has experience, I might come up with something, but I always expect somebody to maybe come up with an idea if that my idea doesn't work for them. So, and at that moment we were talking about it outside before the show. I presented you with an idea. The only thing you said about it, now, and this is going off of yesterday too, is you were asking me, what is Steve going to do? At that point, I was just trying to tell you that me and Steve are going to work. Now, I did not exactly say that I'm going to overpower him. I might have said I may out-wrestle him, but that's because of the experience level when it comes to the wrestling. But I never once said that I was going to overpower him, because in reality, he should be able to overpower me.
No, I got all that. We talked about that, and everything that you're saying is true. You never said anything as far as the outpower part. However, in the match, that's kind of what happened.
But it like, didn't.
I mean, how about we do it this way? And this is just me just talking with you, because I feel like this is going to get lost in the shuffle, and I don't feel like it needs to. How about you and I, and an impartial party of your choosing, sit down and watch the match together? And then we can see what I can point out, what I'm speaking of. Because I understand what you feel is happening, but I also know, like, what took place. Because if we're sitting there and I'm sitting out and I watch you take a bump from Steve and you get pushed down and then you get back up and you try to lock up again and you're able to back him up after pushing, getting pushed down, you're now becoming strong. You're slowly getting stronger in the match, which is fine if that's the route you want to go. I wouldn't have gone that route, especially with you being a smaller person between the two. And before you say that's not what happened, we can look at it, and I'll show you exactly where it happened. You may not have thought that was the case, but the way that it went down, you take a bump from Steve, you then get your bearings, and you're able to push him back a little bit. You may not think that it's a big thing for you, but it's very significant. Considering that your first trial, you get pushed down. So then when you are able to build yourself up to present turtle power, and then you end up on the high end by giving him three shell shots, you've overpowered him. And it started from the lockup. It's kind of like dealing with this. I'm not sure if you watch Dragon Ball. But it's kind of like when someone is holding power back purposely to get an advantage later on. It's like an anime setting. I hope that makes sense. But that's kind of how it wrote. Like, if you go and look at it, you were getting stronger while breaking Steve down. In the way that it's being structured. We didn't talk about that in the back, no. But that's what was being perceived on camera. Now, maybe I'm just an older dude, and it's a different generational viewpoint, which I'm fine with. But from what I saw, and I'm just going end game to end game, from when you started with Steve to where Steve ended up taking a flare bomb after taking three of the shell shocks, I have to look at it from how do we go from him getting pushed on the ground to him being able to share shocking him three times? Because you weren't chaining with him long.
Right. So from the lot, and I kind of want to talk about this here because this is, it just needs to be done. I mean, we can still do your way, but I want for the people that are listening need to understand now my view of what took place here.
I agree.
So from the lockup, are you saying that on that first lockup, Steve pushed me down to where I took a bump?
That's what happened, right?
No. And the thing, to make sure of it, to make sure I'm not lying to myself, I did watch it after I watched the show from yesterday, your thing from yesterday. I watched it today. And then I made sure I watched the match. And what happened is when we locked up, we both struggled. And then when we both went to let go, he had a push on me. One little push. I did not take a bump. Then we went for the lockup again. This time, neither of us moved. I know it sounds weird, but neither of us moved. Then we both let go again. No bump was made. On the third one, I went right for the armbar, going right to it since a lockup was not working for my end. I couldn't, in a wrestling aspect, I could not get a hold on him within the tie-up. So I went for the armbar right away. So there was no bump in the beginning of that tie-up. One bump that I took before you got in, before all the shell shock, I took a big clothesline from Steve. Now, leading up to that, there was some mishaps on Steve's end, which I can't fault him. He's not an active wrestler. He's not going to be able to. I don't know if he just didn't hear me call it, or he forgot, or both. But I was there. There was a mess up there, and then things started to lead to the chop and forearm scenario.
So, what do you want me to say?
Well, I'm just going to go by what you say, that if we're going to tell it. No, I'm saying is.
We're past that. I'm just curious, because based on what you just told me, I'm misinformed. And because of what took place in the match, I clearly didn't see anything. I'm just making it up. So now I need you to tell me, like, what are you asking me to do at this point?
I mean, there's so much, nothing really you can do, but I'm just telling you what actually took place. Because some shit was said on your end.
Which is why I'm saying that we need to sit down together and watch it. Which is, I was very clear in the beginning that we both need to sit down and watch it. With an unbiased party, or we could just watch it together. And we can do it privately if you like, or we could do it publicly in a scenario. Because as bad as it's going to sound, I still stand by what took place. And I feel like we both have a miscommunication, which I'm 100% understanding that falls on me. And the best way to go about it is that we watch it together and work it out. I'm 100% fine with that. Are you okay with it?
I definitely would be down, and I think that should have been the thing that happened in the first place.
Here's the thing. We're past that now. I can't just take any of that back. I've already admitted fault, and that's the thing. No matter how you view this, as far as me giving out misinformation, the one thing you can't deny is that I didn't admit fault to my end. Do you want me to take that back as well?
No, and that's the thing. Like, when I watched it for a second time, I started to feel better as I was actually listening and not, like, listening for what I want to hear or anything. I did hear you say that you are taking blame for certain things and it was all on you, whatever. Whether you're a veteran or not, that part really doesn't matter, because I still think
I'm taking blame for all of it.
But I don't think you really should. To the point where I know I fucked up at some certain points. And I don't know if my idea was good or bad. I wish I was told that my idea sucked. I would rather have been told my idea sucked and to come up with something different or someone else came up with something. I'd rather have that than go in there all pissed off and shit hitting the fan.
Okay. Now, here's the thing, and I know that you're going back and forth in your mind as far as being justified in your actions, but I'm going to say something, and you can tell me if it's right or wrong, if it happened or not, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Do you remember me talking to you about lineage?
Yeah, I remember that.
Do you remember what I said to you as far as the lineage of all three titles?
I honestly do not remember all the details of that.
I was very clear as far as what needed to happen. It's a showcase. Things need to be showcased. Don't fuck me. I was very clear on that. That I'm 100% fine with your ideas. Just don't fuck me. And by me saying that, I'm making sure that you understand that in this scenario, it's not just about you. It's about the three of us. Because we're not just representing IPW, but we're representing Rocket Pro as well. Don't fuck me on this deal that's taking place. Because Rocket Pro, at any time, even though they're allowing us to defend championships in different areas and be able to turn around and be recognized with other stuff, they could easily take those back. You know who's in charge.
Yeah.
They could very easily strip us both because of the way that things are being handled right now. They don't, like, we're just cogs in the machine on their side of things. So you have to look at it from that type of scenario. I've already admitted fault repeatedly. I will admit fault again for misinformation that I gave on the morning after. Can't take it back if that's what happened. But ultimately, I now have to present things in a scenario of I'm in the wrong. Turtle is right. We need to work together. It's the exact same thing I said on the morning after, just not as long. Now, if you want to continue to go down this path of saying, hey, you need to understand my viewpoint of things, we can, but it's going to end up with the same scenario. I've taken responsibility for my actions, not yours. I've taken responsibility for being a veteran in the match and not being able to handle things accordingly, not you. And I've made sure that you understood what was happening in the match from my viewpoint, not yours. I've already admitted fault. If you want me to continue to admit fault, I will. But I'm asking, just like I did as far as giving you everything in the match and then asking you to take a spear, I am asking you to watch it with me and we handle it accordingly. It's literally on you at this point. If you want to continue to tell me that I'm giving out misinformation, you've already made your point and there's nothing I can do to take that back. If you want to go about it and trying to fix it, I've already made the offer. It's just a matter of how you want to handle it, because I've explained this yesterday. This is what happened. This is what I saw. These are the things. I'm asking Travis and I'm asking Steve. So I'm not going to Max, who's not there, for answers. These answers are coming from part of your panel. And at any time, they could have told me that I was wrong. So they're in the wrong as well, based on what took place. They are all in the wrong. And if that's the case, I have manipulated them to thinking that something happened where it didn't, even though one of them was in the match and the other was watching it. So for that, I am sorry as well for putting misinformation out there and manipulating the situation accordingly. I can't take that back. I am sorry. Where do we go from here?
All right. So I will take you up on your offer to watch it with you. I think that's what we need to do.
Mm-hmm.
And whenever we're both ready to do that, we will do it.
You let me know when you're ready. As you can see, I will make time.
Yeah, I got you. I know that. I do. Okay, so I know you're taking responsibility. I get it. I want to do this now for me. I'm taking responsibility for shit that I did, because there is no way I should have been in that situation. And whether you, and I'm going to take you out of this, out of your part in this, out of it for a sec. I should have done better mentally when it comes to this match. I don't know why I let shit get to me. And I know I am a fucking stubborn motherfucker sometimes, where I think I'm listening, but I'm not. I get this argument from my better half every day, so I understand that. I guess we don't need to go through everything that was said now, because we pretty much...
Whatever you want to go through, that's what I'm trying to explain to you. When I say make it for everybody always, I mean that. I'm willing to put myself on the cross to make sure that you understand that there's nothing to hide. But it's the same mentality that I had in PCW. You remember PCW, right?
Yep.
You remember when they had an issue with me when I was like wrestling Max and they were talking about stripping a title and firing me? Do you remember that?
Was that when you were champions for two different, or you were champion for PCW and he was champion for someone else?
Yeah, you remember that, right? You remember how the locker room was pissed off?
I don't think I was part of that, because I was never like, did this happen at a show, or was it at like the school or something?
The reason I'm bringing that up is because on this particular day, it was one of the first times we wrestled at Franklin Park. They pulled me in the back to let me know they were willing to fire me because of the things that I was doing. And I said, what did I actually do? I promoted a championship in another company. I made sure the belt was in a safe place. And I didn't disrespect the company that I was working for at the time. What did I actually do? And they went back and forth with me because there were some people that were on the board that were upset with the way I handled things. And I told them on that day, if I have to go in front of the locker room, because they're making it seem like the locker room is upset, I'm like, I'm willing to go out in front of the locker room and deal with whatever is going to be said right now so we can move on. I'm handling this the exact same way. I'm willing to take whatever you need to do to get it done. I'm willing to go. The thing is, and this is what a lot of people don't understand because they don't have this type of mindset, I'm willing to put myself out there. Based on what you just explained to me, you are not. And I 100% understand that. But I'm also willing to go about it in different parameters. You want to watch it privately? Good with that. You want to watch it publicly? Good with that too. Can't take back what I said. But I stand by everything I said on the other side. And until we watch it together, there's nothing I can do. I can only be responsible for things that were said. And if they were harmful, that's on me. I've already apologized. I've already got that stuff out of the way. But you shouldn't have to apologize for being yourself. Like, I get it. That's one of the things that I personally enjoy about you being around, because I know your history. You shouldn't have to be apologetic for being yourself. I get it. That's not what this is. This is a different ball game entirely, which is why, and I'll say it again, if you want to watch it, we'll watch it. If you don't, that's fine too. But I feel like it would be a very big load off of both of our shoulders if we just watch it together and figure out what happened.
Right. I agree 100%.
So what do we do now?
Well, we just make time to watch it. There's one thing I do want to say now, just because everyone's listening. It was about the, in the match after I got hit in the ear.
Mm-hmm.
So that would be the second time something happened to me in a match where it freaked me the hell out. Didn't know how to handle it. And I did not want to do something that, now I'm not making a threat or anything, but I just didn't want to do something that we or I would regret, or, we both regret or something, because I didn't know how to handle it. And if I were to handle it how I was thinking, somebody or both of us would have been possibly hurt. So I had to step away, get my bearings back, get back to who I am, and just get to back to the working. And it took me a minute or so to get back into myself. So when you saw me cower to the corner, that's me trying to maybe mentally call an audible, because something just happened and I cannot handle it.
I respect that. Here's a counterpoint. You've been in enough matches, you've refereed enough matches, you understand how the business works. In that environment, you don't have time to just say, wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute. You got to go.
That's a regret. That's one of my regrets.
Like, you've been in enough situations where things just happen. I've taken multiple injuries in matchups. And the only time that I've had the opportunity to be like, okay, give me a minute, is when I'm like physically have rolled out of the ring and called the referee over. Hey, tell them I need a minute. Hold on a second. Otherwise, it continues. Because it's even with shoots, even with like actual shoots where there's closed fists and guys are like actually trying to hurt themselves. Like, you have to present it in a scenario, especially when you're having a match. It's one thing when you're blurring the line. It's another thing when someone is like actually, being hurt. Like, the referee should be able to step in and be like, hey, what's going on? Or the guy that's in the match itself that is potentially injured needs to just be able to go. And that's a matter of like pain threshold, so to speak. And I only reason I bring that up is because, like, just recently, Okada and Danielson just had a match at Forbidden Door where Danielson broke his arm. That should have been an audible. That should have been, hey, he just broke his arm. We need to figure this out. But Danielson just kept rolling for another 10 minutes. It's just a matter, like, there's, I don't want to say there's levels to it, but there's ways of handling it. Because if I had known ahead of time that happened, okay, we can fix it. It's fine. Let's slow it down. We're good. But I'm also thinking, okay, he's coming back tit for tat. We should be good. So then when especially if you're the one that initiates things, when you back away, it's like, no, you need to back me away. You need to be the aggressor. You can't start off as the aggressor in what you were trying to structure and then back away. That's like, this doesn't help you.
No.
For what you're trying to do, in a match, this doesn't help you. Which is why I was like, let me talk to you and get you back on track. So it wasn't a scenario of, as far as both of the ear things. Keep in mind, as I said on the morning after, my ear was ringing an hour after the show ended. Mm-hmm. Like, I didn't hear anything until maybe 8 o'clock that day in my left ear, which I was fine with. If it had if it was persistent, I would have went to the doctor and like, hey, go from there. But this is not the first time where I've been clocked in the ear from a wrestling standpoint. Like, that goes back to me being in high school when I wrestled in 145, 148. Like, it's something that happens. Like, I'm okay with it, but I've also been in multiple scenarios like what took place on Sunday, where someone is just more heavy-handed than the other guy. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, the only thing I could say is, my bad for hitting you in the ear. I can't really say anything else, because I'm not going to take away my stance from the strike and say that I still feel like you should have beat me. If that's the route we're going, I still feel like you should have beat me. My apologies for getting you in the ear, but you should have beaten me no matter what.
Yeah,
and it did not help you that you backed away. I understand why you backed away, but it did not help your case. That's why I was like, no, you need, let me stop doing this, and you need to get on top, and you need to unload on a bunch of stuff consistently to where they're going to have to break me down. Because if I didn't go that route, that chant of shell shock, that chant of cowabunga wouldn't have happened. They wouldn't have believed you.
Right.
But this also goes back to what you were saying before. And this is a question I have for you. Is this me giving away too much of the match?
The way we're talking about it, like in real time, like no character, no gimmick, it just seems like it's being talked about too much, like too much is being said. But I get it. So
it's no what I do in the morning after.
I guess you can say I was shell shocked by the situation.
Oh man, you did the shell shock jokes. Oh, did you get anyone with the joke I told you about?
Oh, not yet. I have to do it. I have to do it out of nowhere. I can't just do it now.
Do it with the packs. Yeah. I'm sorry, Pacman. Do it to Pacman. Real quick. Pacman. Right.
Pacman.
Yes, sir.
Knock.
Who's
knock.
There?
You.
You who?
You about to be shell shocked.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Oh, that is great. That's so great. All right, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. All right, please continue, sir, if you have anything else.
No, we pretty much covered everything all in one. I'm happy now. I got to say some things. Yeah, we will have to watch it to get more perspective from both sides at the same time. But I see things, you see things, so we're good at this point. So
I'm glad and thank you.
I just wanted to say my side of it. That's all I cared about.
I get it. 100% I get it. And I'm glad you're able to speak. Is Travis around? Or is he like in the washroom or something?
No, I'm still here. Been here the whole time. Eating chips, drinking beer.
All right.
It's like watching my own show. It's amazing.
Well, I'm glad I could help. Are we good on this forefront of things?
I mean, I honestly believe that the whole reason we did this is because Nubby really wanted to throw a shell shock joke out there. They really didn't give a shit about anything that happened yesterday. He just wanted that one moment. But I'm happy.
Okay. All right.
I mean, honestly, it's like I said, like I wasn't going to benefit or get hurt by anything that happened on this show. This was merely for Nubby to get an opportunity to say what he wanted to say. And if you guys are cool, I'm good with it.
I am 100% good. I was good yesterday. I'm great now. I'm great now because now we have gotten that out. We've gotten all of Turtle's inner thoughts out into the world.
Which I think is really just what he wanted to begin with. He just wanted to be heard.
I'm fine with that. Hence why I told you I will make time to get that out the way because that's mm-hmm. what I am. I'm okay with doing it. Make it for everybody always. I'm 100% fine with that.
Cool.
So Nubby, I don't know. Go ahead.
I was just asking Nubby if you had anything you needed, anything else you wanted to say to you, so we don't have to keep you here any longer than you need to be.
None really. The only other thing that I forgot to mention at the beginning, the other thing that did bother me is when I felt like I was being buried, which I know I wasn't now, but I just felt like now if other workers hear this or heard the story, watched it, whatever, that they're not going to trust me to put a match together or want to work with me. That was another fear I had.
Well, if that's the case, make sure that they listen to the part where I slapped you in the face. So your mindset was completely different. If anything, they're not going to want to work with me. Like, you have a reason for dealing with stuff from a mental standpoint. So if anyone decides that they are like, I'm unsure of Turtle's ability, what is a Turtle related thing that can be said right now? Other than shell shocked. They can shock their own shells if that's the case. And relate to the idea of that you are a pretty good worker. But at the same time, we all need help. If you weren't a good worker, you wouldn't be able to say that you're Rocket Pro Wrestling Chicagoland champion.
So that's another, as we're talking about it, I start to think like, well, why I wouldn't be at Rocket Pro, or Crash Tested wouldn't be having me wrestle. They'd be having me ref like I used to and all that. So if people don't want to work with me now, then they were blind before. Then I should say it that way.
Yeah. They can fuck themselves. Who cares?
Right.
Fuck them. I think the biggest thing to realize too is if you're going to be booked in a match with somebody and somebody has a problem with it, they should go to the guy who booked you. And I'm sure anyone who does book you is going to have nothing but nice things to say about you. People just don't need to be petty. And I noticed that a little bit more as like I get more involved in the business is that, you know, like especially booking shit is when like I hear like, you know, somebody says like, oh, I don't know if I can put those two together because they really don't get along. It's like, get through the match and worry about your own personal shit later. I don't understand that stuff. Like, it's a business. But, like, you want to sit there and like, oh, you know, that dude, you know, dated my girlfriend after we broke up. It's like, who gives a fuck?
Right.
Go out there, have a match, make your envelope, and, you know, let's move on with the day. Don't ruin a card just because you have a petty issue with somebody because 6 years ago they didn't give you the shine that you wanted in a match. It makes no sense to me. But,
right.
Yeah.
But you'd be surprised how much that still exists.
Oh yeah, I've had situations like that when like you try to book matches and you hear that stuff is like, well, at least let's just talk to them and see. And like at least 25% of the time, maybe a quarter of the time, where that conversation actually happens and they have no idea what you're talking about. It's like exactly. I'm fine with so and so. What are you talking about? And then vice versa. It's like so. It's just you know. What's that thing that Conrad Thompson says? Telephone, telewrestler, whatever the hell it's called. But it's just, yeah, it's just the speculation that everyone hears, and it's just how rumors spread. Like, oh, so and so can't work with so and so because of this. But then you go to ask, it's like, I got no problem wrestling them. I got no problem. I've worked with them many times. It's like, it's amazing how much I don't miss high school now that I'm part of the business. because everything is the same thing, you know. So-and-so likes so-and-so, but so-and-so's mad because of this. And I've seen that shit everywhere, and it's nuts.
The thing that I can say more so than anything else, and this is me giving kudos to Turtle, mm-hmm. is that at the very least, you can see that he is very passionate as far as what he does, and he wants to continue to do what he loves. As far as what took place, like, between yesterday and today, I wish more wrestlers did what we just did. Mm-hmm. Where something gets said and they don't like it, they could just talk it. They could just, here's the thing, I don't agree with it, let's talk, okay. I wish more wrestlers did that, as opposed to what you're dealing with. Not what you're dealing with personally, but just the idea of pettiness. I wish more wrestlers as a whole were able to do what myself and Turtle just did today, and just be able to just talk, just head up. The only thing that would have made it better is if we were standing in front of each other.
Yeah. And I think it was one of the biggest things, like, we did discuss yesterday, like, kind of on and off, was a big part of the business is communication. Mm-hmm. And like, there's a lot of things that can be resolved just by talking. Like I said, I mean, like when we spoke, because we talked about, like, one of the reasons you wanted to do yesterday is because there were certain points we talked about in JFW, but we didn't talk about everything. And the same thing on the Power Hour. Like, sections of things were talked about, but it wasn't, you know, talked about as a whole. So there's bits and pieces that were missing. And that was the whole point of yesterday, my guess is to get the whole story out there. It would have been a lot better, you know, if Nubby was there, but yeah, Nubby wasn't invited for pancakes, so.
The way that I viewed it is that, especially going back and forth and listening to both the you guys and the Power Hour, is that everyone wanted to talk about it, but not really. Like, things would get said, and it's like, and the thing that, and this is just me from a personal standpoint, is that both Steve and Turtle love to talk about themselves when it comes to the wrestling aspect. So mm-hmm. when I see that they're talking about a match that they're in and they're kind of dodging certain things, I'm like, no. I know you both like talking about yourselves on these shows. How many times has he given results? And I'm talking to you, Mr. Travis. How many times has he gotten on here on when you're doing reviews of things and he gives you his match last, regardless of where the order is? How many times?
He does main event himself. I mean, I think I would do the same too, though. You know, you gotta mark out for yourself.
And I'm fine with that. I'm gonna ask this to Pacman. I'm gonna ask this to Pacman because he's new to the thing. How many times since he's been on here, where if there's a certain accolade that's taking place with a match that he's describing, he can tell you exactly what happened in the match with him.
Yeah, he doesn't want to answer.
And Steve's the same way. And the reason why I put this out there is because when it came to that match that we're all in, no one, like, it's the most that I've ever heard, Mr. T, if you don't mind me saying this, that I've heard you speak on a match that you're not involved in. It's the most I've ever heard you talk about a match. So then when I go on the other side and Steve, and it's one of the few times where I actually go into the studio, so to speak, and I'm listening to him, and he's like, how do you feel? I was like, you know, I can't say certain things on here because of the way it's structured. This is your structure. Why are you not talking about your experience?
Yeah, and it was
there.
Yeah, and me and Nubby talked a little bit. I think it was, like, right before you came back on, and we're talking about how when we talked about it last week, there was only very little we discussed about it. And one of the biggest reasons we do that is because, from my point of view, from my end of it,
there's still that wonder on how much I could really talk about it. Because even though I do podcasts about wrestling, I still don't see myself really in the business as much as you guys would be. So, like, for me to ask Nubby to give more of a behind-the-scenes look, I don't know where we could really go with that, where it would be okay with, you know, like, upper brass at IPW, you know? I mean, does that make sense?
The way that you have it structured, right?
Yeah, because, I mean, like, obviously we talk about the work side of everything, and I want to talk about, from my perspective, the things that looked like a shoot. So, I can talk about the things from my perspective, but the stuff outside of that, I don't think I am allowed or okayed to do those things because I don't want to jeopardize my relationship with other companies. That's why, like, when I see things, it doesn't matter if it's SCW, RocketPro, IPW, ARW, like, I always look at, I can talk about what I see from my perspective because everything else that's behind the scenes, it's a no-no. Because of where I'm at, you know?
And that's where I come in. Because yeah. I already have one toe out. I have one toe in the business right now. Mm-hmm. And I'm happy for everything I've been able to do. But I also know that there's a lot of companies that are okay with me speaking on it because I'm never talking down about certain aspects.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, I can give you behind-the-scenes scenarios, but I also do it in a way where it doesn't hinder anything as far as the actual behind the scenes process. Like, I don't go out of my way. Like, I'll make jokes about certain things. And if you really want to know certain aspects, I'll talk to you. But that type of stuff, I won't stay on here. But anything that I feel like it's comfortable to where it's common knowledge, to where it's out there, I'll speak. Like, if someone problem with what I'm saying, I have no problem talking with them directly, like how I came on here and spoke with Turtle. But I've also been around for a while, and I'm able to say certain things accordingly.
Yeah, you got that leeway that where you're allowed to do stuff like that, you know. I don't see myself being there just yet. Maybe one day I'll be able to you know, be able to do things like that. But I know, like, right now it's let me deliver what I'm seeing from my opinion. And when I meet people like you or Nubby, Steve, Max, anyone who could dive more into that where people aren't going to question it because, you know, it's okay for people at certain levels to do things like that. I'm okay being a part of those conversations because then that's why I can really learn more than anything.
Fair enough. I'm sorry for all of the noise, but I'm finally getting out of my vehicle.
No, dude, you're fine. Like I said, I mean, you came through on everything you said. I heard everything fine. It wasn't that big of a deal, and I got to enjoy watching JFW, so I mean, it was a win-win for me.
Yeah, that works.
Ah, look at the smile on Pac-Man's face when you showed up. Yeah. You got all dirty and everything. Like, you guys...
Yes. Rattle around. I do like this table. This is the first time I'm able to look at the table. That's hilarious.
Did you know that today is Pac-Man's birthday?
I did not.
Yeah. Turn 19 today.
Thanks for outing me on the fake ID, Travis.
Yeah. Everything's about you fake.
Happy birthday.
Thank you, sir.
I actually just came back from celebrating my dad's birthday, which was the 2nd. So, yeah.
Oh, happy birthday, to your father.
Happy birthday, yeah.
Yeah, so. Do we give out, like, birthday licks to you now, or how does that?
Yeah, you want to hold his you want to hold his birthday chops to the next IPW show?
Oh, God. As long as Marche's not there.
Like, how do you want to do that?
Well, he's turning 89 today. So
okay. I think you're aging me by quite a lot there.
Years, sir. 70 years. I'll do the math for you. 70 years.
Jesus.
Yeah, so yeah, we'll just throw him in a corner, let everyone line up, and you know, give him his chops. 70 apiece, I think is fair. You know, maybe have a few different battle royals that have different guys in them.
If you go by the workhorses themselves, that's 210. If you just take those three by the count you just gave, that's 210 chops.
Oh yeah. Oh, Pac-Man can handle it.
No, it's just the workhorses. I'm 70, so maybe I'm a little brittle for that.
It's just the workhorses. No one likes them.
They'll probably fall off the ring while trying to do it.
The one will spend more time flexing. So.
Well, yes.
That is fair. Rion, I appreciate you coming on, man. And from my understanding, the morning after might be coming a more regular thing coming soon.
I don't know. As I told everyone, literally, it lives through Max, it dies through him. Mm-hmm. When he's ready, he'll let me know.
Awesome, man.
And basically, what I just dealt with, who knows? Maybe this isn't the right time to deal with it, because I don't want wrestlers coming at me in real life and ready to go with me. That would be silly. Why would I even want that type of smoke? You see what I did there, Turtle? You see what I did?
Okay. So on that, well, let me just talk about that real quick. I did not even mean to say that. Say the dumbest shit at the wrong time. And
I
could have said anything.
Did you ask him to come get the smoke, or did you ask him to bring you the smoke?
No, I told him to come get the smoke.
Oh, okay.
So I originally wanted to say, come get this ass whooping. That was in my head all day up until that point. All of a sudden, talking about smoke, I'm like, that's not turtle-like.
It's so.
I fucked up my own gimmick doing that.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hey, Pacman, after hearing all this, you still want to get in this business?
I'm definitely still interested in the business, yeah.
Well, come get your birthday chops. When's the next IPW show? July 30th?
July 30th. Sunday, July 30th.
Oh, birthday chops are coming.
Well, you know, I'll be there.
Happy birthday chops.
I'll get, like, that Bret Hart, like, chest thing from, like, that Goldberg thing just to, you know, soften the blow a little bit.
You realize that was across the abdomen, not his chest.
Well, you know, you could make one. Well.
I mean, you get the D'Lo Brown catcher protector, the chest protector.
I'll do some neck exercises for that show then.
Get some
forearms. Neck exercises.
Rion, I do appreciate you coming on and talking, man. Thank you very much for taking the time out to do it.
No problem, Bob. I mean, Mr. Travesty. That is hilarious to me still, knowing that.
It makes
me like, no. How long has that been a thing? Travesty? That's genius. That is genius.
For the better part of 15 years. It makes me wonder how many people don't know that. Like I assume everyone knows that, but maybe there's more people out there who didn't know that.
Hey, it blew my mind when I found out about it, and that was during the 100th episode. I was like, holy shit, that's amazing. How did I not see that before?
Oh, shit. All right, we'll let you go. You enjoy the rest of your evening, and maybe we'll get you back on in a little bit, you know, and you can correct Nubby on more of a shit.
He corrected me, sir. Are you kidding me?
That's not what I'm believing.
Oh, Jesus Christ. All right.
All right, man. You take care.
All right. See you guys.
Later, Rion.
That worked for you, Nubby? Are you a little more content?
I'm good. We just, like he said, just sit and talk about it more.
Yeah.
100%. Just to get it all out there. He needs to see what I'm talking about now when it comes to that part with Steve. But
gotcha. Well, Pac-Man, that was your birthday gift, so I hope you enjoyed it.
I appreciate it. It was very well.
And this was all a work. We just wanted Rion to come on for your birthday.
Ah, you guys got me.
Yeah, we got breakfast together yesterday just so we could plan this all out.
I was actually there, but I was under the table cleaning up the mess.
He was a camera guy that kept dropping the phones.
Yeah. The return of Butler Nubby Jones.
Oh God. That name was actually Michael Nubblesworth.
Nubblesworth.
Yeah. Well, I thought it would wait. It was Nubsworth, but Dave Allen kept calling me Nubblesworth. I'm like, what? Fine, stick with it.
Oh, fucking A. All right, we got to do match cards.
Yeah. We got a couple shows coming up. I have a few matches for Northland Pro Wrestling.
Okay.
I once worked for them.
Wait, did you say you got a couple matches or a couple shows?
Couple matches.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
Yeah, I was given very few.
That's the Wisconsin one, right?
Nah, it's they're from Woodstock, but they're gonna be in Lake in the Hills, which is pretty much a mile away.
Gotcha.
But yeah, Northland Pro Wrestling presents. Lake in the Hills. Yeah, that is a weird fucking name for a town.
I mean, oh God!
I've been through there. I don't know where the lake is, and where is it in the hills?
What's more weird, Lake in the Hills or Back of the Yard?
Why can't they just call it Backyard?
Because Back of the Yard is a subdivision in Chicago, right?
Mm-hmm.
The suburb, right?
Yeah.
I know I can be wordy, but like Backyard, it writes itself.
I remember when I first heard it, someone was like, yeah, man, I'm from Back of the Yard. I'm like, the back of what yard? No, man, that's where I grew up. I'm like, you grew up in a backyard? Man, you don't know shit about Chicago. I'm kind of proud of that shit.
I'd rather not know everything about Chicago because
exactly.
Chicago.
Yeah, Travis Turtle. Less you know, the better. I'll tell you that.
And if you're offended by a statement, well, you can go fuck yourself.
Fuck them.
Plain simple. Fuck Chicago.
Tell you what, I'll go to Chicago when they stop murdering people. So
yeah,
give me one weekend where they don't got like 5+ murders, and I'll fucking go.
I mean, as a Sox fan, I refuse to go to a game.
Yeah. Wasn't there just a shooting not too long ago?
There was I believe, a carjacking or something.
Yeah, a car, like, drove through, like, that neighborhood, like, right where the park is.
Yeah.
Some people got hurt. That was a couple weeks ago.
Yeah. Well, I know there was that shooting on Juneteenth in Willowbrook. Talking about that in this freaking show. But I thought there was another mass shooting, but I just probably assumed it was Chicago.
I think that was not in Illinois, I don't think.
Okay. Chicago weekend shootings, 3 killed, 5 minors among 22 hurt. Good job, city. How's that gun ban working out for you? Northland. Got matches. When's the show?
I'm glad you asked.
Thanks.
Because Northland Pro Wrestling Road to Redemption is this Saturday, July 8th. Awesome. At the American Legion, 1101 West Algonquin. Algonquin Road in Lake in the Hills. If you find that lake, let me know.
Yeah. Dude, the only Algonquin Road I know is the Splains.
It is an outdoor show, so weather pending. Doors open at 4 p.m., which, by the way, there are really no doors to open because it's an outside. And parking is a little funky. That's at 4 p.m. and bell time is 5 p.m. So a little earlier because there's really no lights for it to be a night show. I mean, they'd have to really put it directly under the streetlight for it to work. Let's see. Tickets are $25 general admission. One of the matches in, that I was given, Haven Harris.
Does anyone listen to our show from Northland?
Well, they are CSW people, so maybe.
All right, I was going to say, that's a pretty pricey fucking ticket.
Yeah. Well, you got to remember, I worked there before. So. That was when I was a manager for Metalhead.
Oh, Primetime Pimp?
No, it was just Evil Turtle.
Evil Turtle.
He exists. He existed.
I'm telling you right now, man, fucking Nubby Jones' heel needs to fucking make an appearance before you call it quits.
I mean, it's no different than Evil Turtle, just he's Nubby Jones, but...
Yeah, but I'm imagining you throwing your fucking turtle fucking gear down and just being Nubby Jones. Like a Jay Jensen-esque guy, but without the dog collar shit. Just more of like a... It's like a badass. It's a badass. Fuck yeah. Like a Taz. Funny. Like a fucking Taz, brother.
So, there was a time back in the league, but I was working for a different company.
You could be
a lot of us were working at this company called War. Yeah, I wouldn't say working for him because I worked one match and that was it. It was me and Brett Michaels, not to be confused with Poison's Brett Michaels,
the guy who cleans the pools.
Yeah, and he's a photographer too. I went in there and I was a heel. I had this shirt because I didn't have gear yet. I was given pants. It was a hand-me-down from one of the guys. Everyone in that school wore those pants in their first match. I had this shirt, and it said, out on bail. So I wore that when I wrestled there. And I felt like, okay, so what is this gimmick? Nubby Jones was in jail? What did he do? You know, it was weird. But where am I at? Oh, Haven Harris will be taking on Lily Ruiz. Eric Schultz, the Northland Pro champion, will be taking on Moondog Murray. And Metalhead versus Cypher in a hardcore matchup.
That'd be a good one.
Yeah. These two go way back. I mean, you can ask Steve. Ask him about the new standard. Steve Boz will be in attendance. As well as the All-Heel Wrestling promotion will be there as well. There have been some inter-promotional stuff going on between the two.
I'm trying to remember where I heard that name before.
All Heel Wrestling?
Yeah, I think Leslie Michelle Russell's there.
She does.
Okay.
I think she's a women's champion.
I believe she is. I don't quote me on that, but I think she is. But I think she might be on the Northland Pro side of things.
Oh, dang.
Yeah.
Catching all that, Pac-Man?
I beg your pardon?
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Deaf is a turnip. My bad.
That was all the information I was given at this time. For more information, check out Northland Pro Wrestling on Facebook, as well as All Heel Pro Wrestling on Facebook. You can catch their show information on that as well. Again, it's this Saturday, July 8th at the American Legion, 1101 West Algonquin Road in Lake in the Hills. Doors open, or not. No doors. 4 p.m. bell time. 5 p.m. general admission. 25.
No doors.
There really is no doors. It's outside.
Doors open what? Up. Nope.
once you park your car, you go right. Walk right in.
Right. Field opens up. Come on in.
Well, I mean to get out. of the car to go outside, you do have to open a car door. So technically,
way to be in the ball. Way to be in the ball there.
Don't open your car door until fucking three.
Yeah. Get out and have a smoke, walk around your car, go back in, cool off, because it's probably going to be hot, and then open it back up to go back out into the arena.
I don't think, and so, like, when you say outside shows, I mean, like, I count outside shows as being ones that aren't in, like, tents and shit. But that's how I see it.
They don't put a tent over the ring.
Remember the first DWA show in Tinley Park? I don't count that as an outdoor show because it was inside the tent.
Right.
So I have never been to an outdoor wrestling show, technically. Boys in a tent or some shit.
And it's funny because when this was after you left Elite Pro, we had an outdoor show, but it was under a tent. So really,
where do you draw the line? Pac-Man is it tent. Is that making an outdoor show or not?
I mean, I have only been to one outdoor.
Okay, answer. And shut up, you're done. No, okay, let's move on.
All right.
You had an opportunity to answer. Just because it's your birthday, I'm not gonna fucking allow you to do shit. Like, now go ahead and answer the question.
So. You know, I think that would make a difference. Definitely. If it's a hot day, keep it a lot
cooler. No, see, I gave you a chance to fucking answer the question. And again, you're babbling.
I think I did my best.
No. Do you consider a ring under a tent an outdoor event? Yes or no?
I consider it an outdoor event.
Okay. That's all I needed to know. I didn't need based on air conditioning and the way the fucking sun's looking at me, you know, with the economy and gas prices and how they're fluctuating and everything. Plus, we're not doing daylight saving times anymore. So really, 6 o'clock is always six. No, yes or no, the fucking question, bro.
I answered it. So fucking, I said,
you know,
yes.
Fucking the sun, we were around the sun 29 times since I've been alive. I don't give a fuck.
It's a lot of times, considering.
Let me ask you a question, Pac-Man.
Sure.
And I just want you to answer the question. I'm asking you this because it's your birthday.
Okay.
Okay. So today is your 29th birthday.
Yes, it is.
So there's two ways you can look at it. And I want to know how you look at it.
Okay.
Okay. So you're celebrating 29 years on this earth.
Mm-hmm.
Which means yesterday was the last day of your 29th year on earth. Today starts your 30th year on Earth.
Oh, God.
So when you have a birthday, that's the day you were born, which is day one of your 30th birthday, your 30th year of life. Why is it called your 29th birthday when you technically should be celebrating your 29th birthday the day before your day of birth?
Well, it's the 29th anniversary of when I was born, right?
That's like, how it's called. It's not called an anniversary. A birthday. It's not your 29th birthday.
I have a perfect example. Wrestling example. 25th
WrestleMania.
WrestleMania 25. They called it the 25th anniversary of WrestleMania. Was it? It wasn't. It was the 25th WrestleMania. It was technically the 24th anniversary of WrestleMania 1.
So how do you look at it?
I look at it as it's the 29th anniversary since I was born.
And yet it's the first day of your 30s.
Oh, God, don't rush me into that. Gets me into 20 years closer to an AARP card. I can go 21 years.
Right. When you turned one, that was the beginning of your second year of life.
I'm trying to follow your Steiner math at this point.
No, it's logic. It's logic. I'm not saying on your first birthday you lived for 2 years, but on your first birthday is the beginning of your second year of life. So when people say it's like, oh, well, I turned 30, so now I'm in my 30s. No, technically you are in your 30s because this is your 30th year of life beginning today.
So, okay. 94, carry the one. No, I still think I'm right.
What were you right about?
Because it would be the 29th anniversary of when I was born. I could kind of see where you're going, but again, WrestleMania logic. 25th anniversary of WrestleMania. Mm-hmm. That was actually the 24th anniversary of the first WrestleMania.
Okay.
But it was still the 25th WrestleMania because in that sequence, it was the 25th edition of the show.
Okay, so when WrestleMania was born, it was born WrestleMania 1.
Yeah.
When you were born, you weren't 1 year old when you were born. You weren't one until a whole year later when you started your second year. When you were born, that was the first day of your first year of life.
You know what? I think I'm going to need to consult my dad, Flash Harris, on this one.
Cause... Now, if you also think about it like this, 365 days a year, right?
Mm-hmm.
Today is day one of the next set of 365.
Right.
You're in your
366 because leap year.
Well, you get what I mean.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
I don't want to rush into my
30s. That actually took a lot of brain power. Yeah. Oh, here's some advice for your 30th.
Okay.
Hang out with one group of friends. If you hang out with two groups, that's quadruple the shots.
Oh.
Not a good day.
Yeah, probably not. Alcohol's not going to agree with me. That's why I don't want to rush it.
I didn't make it to the next bar. Let me just say that.
So, food for thought. I'm just saying, technically, you're beginning your 30s. So, you're in your 30s. Congratulations.
Thank
you're
you.
In the 30s club, bro. What's the next show? We're an hour and a half in. We only got this one. That's it, right?
Yeah.
Pac-Man, you got nothing?
I got nothing.
Of course.
Okay. Who won the predictions?
Oh. Yeah, good question.
What?
Who won predictions?
For Money in the Bank.
All right, well, you guys are going to have to make a decision on this one because we all tied.
Oh.
So we all get a point or we all get nothing. I'll leave it up to you to decide.
I get a point.
I like points, but I get double points because it's my birthday.
No, you don't.
Oh, okay. All right.
Now, one point, and here's my logic.
We tied yesterday, 2 days ago.
Oh, yeah.
Here's my logic.
Yeah.
Here's my logic on this. We are consistent.
Yeah.
So ties should be automatic wins for us because if the others decide automatically want to just start participating like they should have been, then we should not make it easy for them to catch up.
That's fair. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because I was actually looking at the matches and stuff and I was kind of tallying them as we were going. And I'm looking at it and I'm looking at it like, okay, where are the possibilities of me winning, me losing, and me tying? And it got to a certain point where I couldn't lose. I could either win or I could tie. And I think it was at the point where I was like, if, which match was it? It was if the Usos won, and I think if Roman and Solo won and Nubby won the ladder match, I would have won. Because me and Pac-Man had Roman and Solo and you had the Usos. But I was like, but if Nubby wins the Usos, I need to win the ladder match. So it was a goofy thing. Like either Roman and Solo had to win and Pac-Man had to win the ladder match in order to win. I needed to win the solo match to win, or I think you had to win both. Basically, how it worked is like I was rooting for me to lose the ladder match because I was banking on Roman and Solo to win, and that would have gave me a win. But since Usos won and I didn't win the ladder match, I lost both, which gave Pac-Man a loss, which gave you one win, and neither of us won the ladder match. It's just so that's how we all tied. Oh, yeah, you had to win both. Nubby had to win both in order to win. Pac-Man had to win both. No, you had to win one. It was, yeah, it was a goofy thing. At the end of the day, we all tied. So
we all won.
Yeah, we all got a point. And then,
yay!
So what's the next? I think SummerSlam's in like 5 weeks or some shit like that.
Yeah.
August 5th.
August 5th. Okay. So, and I don't know when the next AEW is. That the Wimbledon one?
All In. I think that's end of August, and then All Out is end of Labor Day weekend.
Okay. So SummerSlam's the next one. Okay.
Yeah.
Cool. All right. ARW.
W presents, right. Yep, Summer Games.
That's ARW and that's ARW and DWA, right?
Well,
I saw DWA. Yeah, that's why I'm wondering.
But it's mostly ARW, probably. I mean, I figure if it was DWA too, I probably would have been called, but I wasn't, which is fine, whatever.
Yeah,
I'll still be there. I'm gonna be there anyway.
Card subject to change.
Usually. So yeah, ARW presents Summer Games at the Bricky Bowl. It's a festival that Hobart has. It's a 705 East 4th Street in Hobart, Illinois. Indiana. Why do I say Illinois every time I say Hobart?
Because you prefer to be in a better state.
Treated. Huh. Indiana just got treated.
I don't know. I prefer to be in Indiana sometimes.
Oh, because it's cheaper?
Yeah.
It's because it's got more meth.
Well, I'm not into that, so...
You ever seen Northwest Indiana?
Dude, I work there, so...
God, it's just... wait, do you really?
Yeah.
Oh, gross.
Right off the border.
Ah, jeez. It's like anything that's north of, like, Sherville, Maryville is just... Gross. Hammond, Highland, Gary,
Munster,
Whiting, Munster, all the way out to, oh God, what the hell is that one that starts with a P? Portage. Yeah.
When I think of Portage, I think porta potty.
Yeah. You know, like when you have a gunshot and like the shot itself looks like shit. But the surrounding gets all bruised and fucked up. And that's what Gary outwards in Northwest Indiana looks like. Just, oh, God. Nice place, though.
Well, I do have fans out there, so People love them.
Don't get me wrong. I got all love in the world for Indiana. Just not, that's not that Northwest corner. Fucking St. John South, Valpo what East, I'm happy with. It's just that shit that got the residuals of Chicago in it, that, you know, yeah. Torrance Avenue. Oh, I used to work off of that.
I used to drive on that going to the strip club.
Ooh, 390?
No.
What type of club, though?
No, never been there.
Skybox?
I always took 294 to those. But when I'm going to Indiana, I have to get on Torrance a little bit. I went.
Oh, for what the fuck is that? That Greek one, Athens or whatever.
No, it was called Industrial.
You went to a strip club called Industrial.
Industrial strip, yeah.
You deserve to get hit in the ear.
Yeah.
I've never heard of that before. How old are you? The fuck, man! You're only like what, 5 years older than me?
Yeah. I mean, well, you were also what? And out in where you're at forever. So.
Well, yeah, but I mean, I've been to 390 and Skybox and Club O, and that's about it. And then there's that big ass one. I think it's called like Athens or some shit. That's off of 394.
Atlantis.
Yeah, there we go. Atlantis. Yeah.
That one was new-ish.
Yeah.
Newer than the other ones, and then the other one shut down.
390, I think, has been the best.
I've had some moments there. But I will not disclose that.
For those of you listening out there, what was your favorite strip club? Share in the comments below.
Definitely wrestling related.
Yeah, who gives a fuck about wrestling? I'm just kidding.
Hey, Mickey Rourke's girlfriend and the wrestler was a stripper, so.
Marissa Tomei, right?
Yeah.
Oh, God, she's hot.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, at
see, Life of a Wrestler. When I watched that movie and I watched that part, I thought of myself.
I think the only part that I would relate to is jumping off the top rope and dying midair. That'd be me. ARW has a show.
They do. At the Bricky Bowl.
Outdoor event.
Outdoor event. Under a tent.
Oh, so it's not outdoors.
As far as I...
It is an outdoor.
No.
It's not outdoor.
Oh, my God. Go away, people.
Fucking fans.
I think I know this person, but it's probably a bot, but whatever.
Pac-Man, what's the title reign for Nubby?
The title reign? Ooh. So, August or April 15th. Today is July 3rd. So it was like
80 something. 90. 100.
You know what? I think I'm going to have a Nubby title counter on my phone.
If I did it right, I think it's 79.
Probably.
Let me check.
I think 4th of July would be 80. 30, 31 is 61 plus 15 is 76 plus 3, so 78. 79. Mm-hmm. 79, cool. There we go. So 4th of July, we'll celebrate 80 days. Look at that.
Awesome.
Yeah. You better do a TikTok on that shit.
On TikTok. Oh, yeah, I do have that, don't I?
You really have a counter now? Is that going to be a counter?
Yep.
Keep that shit, man. I'm going to ask you every Monday.
There. Yep.
So next week when I ask you, you better fucking tell me 86.
Yeah, I'll make sure of it.
Yeah. No, I'm kidding.
All right, let's start over.
We got 18 minutes before I have to have a problem fucking converting this video. Yeah.
All right, ARW presents Summer Games at the Bricky Bowl, 705 East 4th Street in Hobart, Indiana. General admission is $15. Kids 7 and under, you are just $5. Doors open at 5 p.m. Bell time is 6 p.m. So it's a special start time for ARW is not the normal 7. It is the 6 p.m. The proceeds are going to the Hobart Police and Fire Department. So that's good. All right. One of the matches announced, Chavez, your boy, versus Donovan Ruiz. I didn't call him the J word.
That's okay. You don't deserve to be called the J word.
James Creed will be defending the ARW title against CMOS Dave in a Hobart street fight. Have you ever been in a Hobart street fight?
I've never been to Hobart.
No?
I don't think so,
I'm still
scared. I think I remember that.
I'm still scared for life from my Hobart street fight. It was around after Mania 26. I don't like talking about it.
You know, I wish you didn't celebrate WrestleMania 20.
Hey, joke's on you. You don't have birthday candles today to make a wish. Treated.
Unlike you, I can go buy my own candles and not ask my mom to pull shit out. Oh, can you go grab the 6 and the 9 from when I was fucking, 6 and 9?
We thought we had candles. We didn't. I opened the drawer where they normally were. Those were the two I could find. But I was very happy because it was 6 and 9, and I thought, nice, The end.
Yeah, we got 15 minutes.
Yep.
At the last show, JPH made a challenge to Greg Glover, and Greg Glover accepted the challenge. So it'll be JPH versus Greg Glover. How about that? For the Indiana State Championship, we have a special four-way. It is Nick Diamond, the champion, versus Dave Allen, versus Kazile, versus Mason Perks.
Oh shit, at ARW, really?
Yeah, those boys are getting around. Okay. They want to collect titles everywhere they go. Silas Young is making his ARW debut as he takes on Scotty Forever Young.
Forever Young. I wanna be forever young.
So I just realized it's Young versus Young.
Oh, dang.
I think Young's gonna win.
Next match. It's okay. He can't talk anymore. There's a train coming.
Quinn Whittick.
Yes. I just also saw this match.
Also made a challenge to anybody.
Yeah.
And only one person. One person had an answer.
So
funny. I mean, I kind of answered it, but I get ignored. It's the one. The only, the guy that hasn't wrestled in Illinois in such a long time, or even Indiana. See, I corrected myself. John Hudson.
Fucking Hudson.
3%.
It's, God, it's, it had to have been almost 2 years now.
Just about, maybe. Was it Steam Hollow that we last saw him when they won the titles?
Yeah, I honestly do. I don't even think they ever had a title defense with them, too. I think it was always Angel and Aaron. But, yeah, it's, I want to say it's been about 2021 since he's been around and shit. You know, he's been down in Florida crushing it, showing up on AEW and stuff like that.
Yeah.
But, yeah, no, I'm excited for him to be back. Man, if I wasn't in Lafayette at a wedding this weekend, I'd fucking make it to watch this that match. That's awesome.
Lafayette's pretty far, isn't it?
About 2.5 hours from my house.
So, yeah, that's still 2.5 hours away from Hobart.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, but I'm going to be at a wedding at 3 p.m., so, yeah.
That ain't going to happen. Yeah.
Yeah. By the time I get back up here, it may be the main event, and, yeah.
Yeah. He should have won. Just saying.
God, everyone believes it too.
Yeah.
I got it right. So, go ahead.
Of course you did. I mean, I'm not completely mad. All right, and then for the tag team titles.
Can we agree at least it wasn't Logan Paul?
I agree. Fuck that guy.
God.
That and I'm just gonna blame him for that botch. Him and Ricochet.
Oh, it was. Dude, you could see him trying to, like, reposition his feet and everything. Oh, it was brutal. All I kept thinking about was, like, why even go for the fucking move? Like, there's no way you're going to hit this right the way your fucking feet are on. And, yeah, it was, yeah. Luckily, they both walked away safe, but come the fuck on.
You could be athletic as hell, but if you ain't got balance at the same time, go fuck yourself. Don't even do it. And Logan Paul needs to go fuck himself. He's good at in the ring, but he's just, his cockiness gets ahead of him. So, fuck.
And I bet he doesn't listen to JFW either.
So he can double fuck himself.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, fuck that guy. I don't want Logan Paul even listening to my fucking show.
That's how shitty you are, Logan Paul.
Yeah. Tell you what, you go listen to my show when you're able to go back to fucking China or Japan or wherever you're fucking kicked out of.
Yeah, and then make sure you promote us.
Fuck Logan Paul, in the words of Cheeky Baby. Yeah. I break his back, I make him humble.
And then we got a tag team title match, a gauntlet match. It is the Scumbag Army champions. And the three tag teams that they'll face if they make it through. One team is the MASH Brothers. Not the Smash Brothers, but the MASH. Smash without the S. And then we got the Workhorses. And then we got the Family Prospects. Jay City and Mike Morris. And that is your card as of right now. Any more information, go to ARW Pro on Facebook. As I do that now and try to cheat. Just to see if there's... Oh, there's a battle. Going to be a battle royal. Battle royal.
Yeah, oh, you might get a call, brother.
The winner will be crowned as the new holder of the ARW Golden Ticket. This is the first thing that was just I see. Holy shnikes. I need to call somebody. I need the golden ticket.
I need to call somebody.
All right. So Battle Royal was it just added for the golden ticket. And that is the so far the ARW card. For summer games at the Bricky Bowl, 705 East 4th Street in Hobart, Indiana. General admission, $15. Kids 7 and under, $5. Doors PM. Doors open at 5 p.m. Bell time, 6 p.m. And that is it for the it.
Yeah. Pacman, so I got a surprise for you because it is your birthday.
Okay.
And I wanted to do something nice for you. So I reached out to your fellow LIM members. I reached out to fellow podcasters and said, hey, guys, today is Pac-Man's birthday. Could you throw together just a quick video to wish him a happy birthday and I can play it on the air for him? Not one person got back.
They were probably busy.
But because it's your birthday, I'm going to risk further demonetization. And I'm going to play a song for you, and then we'll end the show. Sound good?
Perfect.
Buddy.
Thank you, boss. I appreciate it. Love you too, brother.
Told you he was going to sing to you.
Hope your 29th birthday was fun.
It was a good day.
I enjoyed having a drink with you. And thank you for still coming and doing the show with us. Hopefully you did have fun through Rion and Nubby's discussion.
No, it was a good time being with you guys today.
Perfect. What do we got next week?
Lee will have these results from the two shows, and then POW will be next Saturday.
Is that one show next week?
Yeah.
I'll have the preview for Destination 6 Wrestling as well.
Okay.
Awesome. Cool.
All right. Videos for these shows are going to start going up more often. I'm going to work in my schedule. The 200th episode video is finally going to be up. It should actually be up right now. Last week's episode, I'll get put up tomorrow, and then I'll try to get this one up in a couple days. There's just no way I'm going to get this and the audio up in the same night. So Monday night audio, and then maybe Wednesday morning, I'll get the video up for you guys. So make sure you check us out on YouTube at Just Freaking Wrestling Podcast. Subscribe and notification bell. Follow us on other social media, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, just by searching JFW Podcast or Just Freaking Wrestling. And find us wherever you listen to your podcast. Just search us, subscribe to us, rate and review us wherever you do listen. Make sure you check out the Lovely Intoxicated Podcast on YouTube or Facebook. Anything you want to say about the next show?
The next show is the fourth episode spectacular. What that means? We don't know. But yeah. Basically, I want you to think of it this way. Podcasting is like dog years, right? So fourth episode in dog years, what? Is that like 4 times 7? It's what, 28? Something like that. I don't know if I did the math right. So like it might as well be our 100th episode. So we're going to treat it as such. So you're going to want to stay tuned because we got some...
Yeah,
you muted
nothing.
Me on my yeah. birthday?
Yeah, I gave up on you. Fourth episode coming out 2 weeks, whatever the hell it is.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Nubby, got anything?
I got nothing.
Cool, that's all I got.
I believe we can...
ring the bell on this episode.
Perfect. As always, I am Travesty.
I am Nubby, the amazing turtle, Cowabunga.
And I am Pac-Man. Shut up, Santino. It's been Acromania, baby.
And thank you for listening to another episode of Just Freaking Wrestling, the JFW Podcast.